There are many teams that can claim the title of the greatest underdogs in history. There's the Iraq national team, who won the 2007 Asian Cup despite being exiled from their war-torn homeland. Or perhaps West Germany, winning the 1954 World Cup final just 9 years after the end of World War II, the so-called Miracle of Bern. But, for pure unlikeliness, Leicester City's 2015-16 English Premier League title is perhaps the longest shot of all. Indeed, famously, you could have got 5,000-1 odds on the team winning the title in the August of that season. One reason that Leicester City's championship resonated around the world was the fact that this kind of thing just doesn't happen in sport anymore. Wages, by and large, correlates with success on the pitch, meaning the richest almost always win. An unfashionable club that, with Claudio Ranieri at the helm, put together a team of bargain buys on a fraction of the budget normally needed to compete. The likes of Jamie Vardy, Riyad Mahrez and N'Golo Kante are all now household names. If it can happen to Leicester, it could happen to anyone, right? Well, not quite. One man who can claim a large slice of credit for that historic success, perhaps even the largest, Thai billionaire Vishay Srivatanaprabha, whose company King Power International owns the club. As with most billionaire foreign owners who acquire English football clubs, little was known about Vishay Rexriexorn, as he was known then, more on that later, when King Power International bought the club in 2010 for close to £40 million. He was one of Thailand's richest men, with a penchant for polo, which King Power also heavily invests in, and for hanging out with the royal families of the world. He'd made his riches in retail, opening his first shop in Bangkok in 1989, but his fortune skyrocketed to over $4 billion thanks to King Power securing the contract for Thailand's lucrative duty-free concessions. By far the biggest earner was the Suvarnabhumi Airport in Bangkok, a hugely expensive pet project of the then Prime Minister Thaksin Shinawatra that was opened in 2006 and came to represent, for many Thais, the largesse of the Thaksin era. In fact, Vishay and Thaksin were close allies. Like Thaksin, Vishay is a member of Thailand's ethnically Chinese elite. Both became billionaires in Thailand's rapidly growing economy in the 1990s, and both decided to invest some of that fortune in English football. Thaksin's one season owning Manchester City between 2006 and 2007 was, it's fair to say, less successful. Still, that didn't put off Vishay, and in 2010, King Power had just signed a 3-year shirt sponsorship deal with Leicester City before deciding to go all in. Famously, Vishay would arrive for games by helicopter, which would land on the centre circle of the newly renamed King Power Stadium. When he took over, Leicester City had just returned from a brief spell in English football's third tier. He became chairman when previous owner Milan Mandrić left, and, soon enough, with Son Ayawat following closely behind and with Nigel Pearson at the helm, Leicester City were back in the Premier League after a few yo-yo seasons. However, in June 2015, Vishay sacked Pearson largely due to the fallout from a video of several Leicester City reserve players, including Pearson's son, involved in a racist orgy whilst on a training camp in Thailand. Claudio Ranieri was hired. Buddhist monks were brought in to bless the pitch and give spiritual guidance to the players. Jamie Vardy scored 13 goals in 11 consecutive games, and the rest, as they say, is history. But things could have turned out very differently for Vishay, whose fortune and success had been made during and connected with Thaksin's regime. Everything was put in jeopardy when a coup removed Thaksin from power, forcing Vishay to placate the country's powerful military elite and ultimately fall back on his close relationship with Thailand's beloved and infallible monarchy. But we're getting ahead of ourselves. Back in 2005, Thaksin had just won an historic re-election campaign, the first Thai Prime Minister to do so given the country's long history of military coups and counter-coups. As soon as Thaksin was elected, a political crisis enveloped the country between pro-Thaksin red shirts and anti-Thaksin yellow shirts. In September 2006, Thaksin was removed from power by the military, who also control powerful business interests. This left Thailand's business elite, who'd got rich during the Thaksin era, with a dilemma. How could they keep their fortunes without being purged like Thaksin had? The answer was to deftly switch allegiances. Soon after the coup, Thailand's military-controlled regime moved quickly to invalidate King Power's duty-free contract. The Airport Authority of Thailand accused Vishay of leveraging his political connections to ensure there was no competitive tendering and the deal was therefore invalid, which Vishay strenuously denied and fought. It was a huge honeypot, Suvarnabhumi Airport alone generated $403 million in sales in 2007. After a lengthy battle, Vishay beat off the legal challenge, but it cost him millions more in back fees and taxes. At the same time, he had allegedly leveraged his political influence to avoid Thaksin's fate. Many believed that corruption was rampant during Thaksin's reign, but dealing with a military dictatorship was a much more opaque affair. If you want to do business in Thailand, these are the people you need to talk to. Business people who are associating with the military, said Dr. Paul Chambers from the Institute of Southeast Asian Affairs in Chiang Mai, Thailand. King power remains influential. The threat by the junta to break off some of the monopoly power of king power didn't happen. Instead, the influential reach of Vishay saved him. It could only have helped that Vishay had long been working hard to raise money for several charities close to Thailand's beloved king, King Bhumibol Adulyadej, who died in 2016. And in return, in 2013, Vishay Raksriaksorn was awarded the royal name, Srivadhanaprabha, meaning the light of progressive glory. As Thaksin remained in exile, to this day in fact, Vishay skillfully maintained his fortune at home by navigating the treacherous waters between pro- and anti-Thaksin factions. But it also involved accepting the new rules of Thailand's political game, which included accepting Thailand's military dictatorship. A second pro-Thaksin government, led by his sister, Yingluck Shinawatra, was also toppled by the military in 2014, and long-awaited elections have been postponed. A referendum on a new constitution, which was seen as a brazen attempt to entrench the military's hold on the country, was lambasted by human rights groups. Vishay is a super wealthy guy, connected to military dictators in Thailand and making sure an underdog team in England win, said Dr. Chambers. It isn't such a Cinderella story. But this is the price of doing business for Thailand's elite. Thaksin Shinawatra believes that Vishay, who he still considers a friend, learned the lessons of what happened to him by avoiding mixing business and politics. He saw my lesson, said Thaksin. Politics is not good for a very successful businessman, but owning a football club has its uses, according to Thaksin. I think that might be a good strategy for him, being a business and then threatened by different camps of politics. And now he is a popular man because of the football club. Somehow, it's an insurance policy. It is good insurance. This doesn't mean that Vishay doesn't face other obstacles. Another lawsuit accusing King Power of shortchanging the Thai government over sales from Suvarnabhumi Airport's duty-free monopoly is currently ongoing, although Vishay and his family are not directly accused of wrongdoing. Vishay's son, Iowa, denied the allegations and said in a statement to The Guardian that King Power has always followed and been absolutely committed to the highest standards in proper ethical business practice. The King Power contract at Suvarnabhumi Airport ends in 2020. Meanwhile, Vishay's interests in football club ownership has expanded. In March 2017, King Power purchased Belgian club Uithuizen Leeuwen. But as ever, the fortunes of Thailand's super rich will depend on the shifting political sands back home.